Welcome back to another real-time dashboard tutorial. Today we will use SQL Server to monitor calls of a call center from various regional offices to various locations around the world. We have a call center and we want to monitor it live and its call performance in real time. The call center data is stored in following format. We will shift this data to our SQL Server and then each call will be logged into our online database. We will then connect our Power BI dashboard to that online server and monitor our call center in real time. Let's create a table in our online database for call center logs. The first column will be the date column, which will store the date and time of call. The origin column will store the location from where the call has originated. It will be one of our regional offices. The destination column will store the location where call was made to. It will be the location of one of our clients. The call duration will be stored in the duration column in minutes. And finally, the call rating will be stored in the rating column. Let's execute our query now. And there is an error in our query. The error was caused by semicolon at the end of each line, when it should be a comma. Happens when you are using multiple programming languages. The table has been created. We can use the select command to access the table and confirm if it was successfully created. Use the select all command and the table name. And execute the query. And here is our table, where the calls from our call centers will be logged. Now we will create a program to bring data of current calls from various regional offices into this database. We have very limited options of interacting with our SQL Server from within our Power BI dashboard. Due to lack of scripting language support, you cannot just create a button to communicate with your server or give commands from Power BI. However, you can use URLs which we can take advantage of. So we have created a script on our web server, which will turn on real-time connectivity for few seconds using a hyperlink. And we will use this URL in our dashboard for real-time monitoring. To use a URL, we will create a table with one column named link and enter the URL into the first cell. This link, when clicked, gives you few seconds of real-time connectivity. Connectivity is limited to few seconds for the purpose of tutorial only. Otherwise, the same method is good for unlimited connectivity as well. Let's give the table an appropriate title and click on the load button. The table will be loaded into the data pane along with its fields. Just add the link field to the dashboard. Rename the column to click here or something appropriate. Go to the table view and change the data category of the link field to web URL. Now, you can click on this link and monitor the call center log in real time for few seconds. Add a text box visual to your dashboard and place it at the top of the page. Enter an appropriate title for your dashboard here. Go to our website and scroll down to the SQL Datasets section. Here you will find a list of tables inside this SQL Server database. We will use this table in our tutorial. This is the address of the SQL Server that we will use in our data source settings. Click on the SQL Server button. In the Server field, enter the SQL Server address. You can copy it from our website. In the Database field, enter the name of the database, which is also available on this web page. Next, you must select Direct Query to display data in real time. Then click on Database and enter the username and password. You can also copy username and password from this website. This username and password allows you to read database. You cannot edit database using this username and password. Now, click on the Connect button to connect to the SQL Server database. In the Navigator window, select the table you want to connect to and click on the Load button to load the table into the Power BI desktop application. Click on the OK button, as this is not a sensitive data. Now you are connected to the log table, which is now available in the data pane, along with its fields. Add a map chart to your dashboard to monitor calls made to various locations. Add the destination field to the location area of the map chart. Add the origin field to the legend area of the dashboard. This will color the bubbles according to the locations from where the call was made, interactively telling you which regional office made the call to this location. Finally, add the rating field to the bubble size to display the bubble sizes according to their rating. Place the map chart appropriately on the page. Another better way to display calls from into various locations is to use Flow Map Visual, which was used in our previous tutorial. Add this visual to your build pane, and then add it to your dashboard. Place this visual below the other map chart. Add the origin field to the origin area of Flow Map Visual, and the destination field to the destination area. Add the rating field to the width area to display the call rating through line width. We can also use duration here if you want to display call duration through line width. Let's move this URL to the top of the screen. Add the duration field to the dashboard as card and change it to average. Similarly, add the rating field to the dashboard as well, and change it to average too. Now, select all visuals and turn on their visual borders, as well as rounded corners. Our dashboard is now ready. Now, turn on the page refresh option and select the page refresh frequency to 2 seconds. Click on this URL to start updating the log table. Keep the web page running in the background. And as you can see, as the table updates, the call logs start appearing on both maps. The map visual only shows the location of call destination and indicates the call originating location through color. But the flow map displays proper origin and destination locations of call center calls. We can also see the average call duration and average call rating. We can display these two using the gauge visual as well. Change both visuals to gauge visuals. Now add a new measure and name it max. Set its value to 5. Add the max measure to the maximum value area of both gauge visuals. Now run the script and see how it looks. Great, the dashboard is working perfectly. And with this, we end our today's tutorial. Let's hope you got some great ideas from this tutorial. Till next tutorial, Please like, share, and subscribe.